Hey guys, Brian Schultz here with Cape Falcon Kayak with a brand new introduction to a video that has been floating around on the channel here for a while, which is the advantages and disadvantages of our skin-on-frame canoe building system. And the reason I'm re-uploading this with this new short introduction is because we've actually solved what I think was one of the biggest disadvantages of our canoe building system, and that is the inability to put Tumblehome into the sides of the boat. Now, if you don't know what Tumblehome is, what that refers to is in the center of the canoe, the side will come inward a little bit before it comes up to the gunwale. And the reason that's important is that if you're a serious solo canoeist, every bit that you can get your stroke closer to the center line of your body makes the boat a lot more comfortable to use, and it also makes your stroke a lot more efficient. And without going into a long technical description of why it was a challenge to add this and skin on frame in general, I'll just say that after a lot of experimentation, I finally found a way to get significant Tumblehome into the sides. Now, is it the same amount of Tumblehome that you're going to see in a modern commercial solo canoe? Not quite that much, but it is a lot more than we were able to do in the past. And speaking personally, this first batch of solos from 2021 here is significantly more comfortable to use as a solo canoe than previous models. Now, whether this matters to you or not just really depends on which canoe you're building and what you want to do with your boat. If you're building a small pack canoe, I would say this is pretty irrelevant. And if you're building a large tandem, it probably doesn't matter either. But if you're someone that really loves to solo, this ability to add Tumblehome into the sides is going to make a big difference in the handling of your boat here. So as you're watching this video and you hear me talking about the advantages and disadvantages of our building system, you're going to see an obvious cut in the video where there's a big chunk missing because I'm no longer going to be talking about how we can't do Tumblehome. And when you see that on the whiteboard next to me, you can just go ahead and ignore that. So that's all I got to say. If you've already watched this video and you're familiar with it, no reason to waste any time watching it again. If you haven't seen this video before, make sure you keep watching because this is going to give you a lot of great information that'll help you make the choice of whether our canoe building system is or isn't a good fit for you. Hey guys, Brian Schultz here with Cape Falcon Kayak, and I just want to take a couple minutes here to talk about the advantages and the disadvantages of our canoe building system. That way, if you're thinking about building one of our canoes, you can decide if it's going to be a good fit for you. Now, there's two basic ways to build a skin-on-frame canoe. You can either make a canoe mold out of plywood forms, just like if you were building a cedar strip canoe. You can wrap it in stringers and bend the ribs in that way. Or you can do what I do, which is to start with a set of mortised and laminated gunwales, more like a skin-on-frame kayak, and use a formula to predetermine the rib lengths and bend those in by eye, and then wrap the stringers around them afterwards. And there's not a better or worse way to build a skin-on-frame canoe. There's just advantages and disadvantages here. So I'm going to tell you all the good things about our system and all the bad things about our system so you can make an informed decision. So the first amazing thing about this system is that it's a very fast build because you don't have to spend time building the plywood canoe form. It takes about half the time of doing it the other way, and you don't have to figure out what to do with that canoe mold when you're done with it. Now, the other cool thing is that it's not very expensive because you don't have to spend the money to purchase all that plywood and build the strong back. And that's especially true if you want to build canoes of different sizes, because in that case, you'd have to build two canoe molds if you were doing it the other way. Now, it's also a pretty easy build as well. I think some people are a little bit intimidated by the free bent system as opposed to working with molds, but once you get in there and you actually do it, you'd be really surprised by how quick and easy this particular method of building a canoe is. Now, after that, we get into some of the functional advantages just of working with a formula-based system. And the first one is the fact that we can make canoes of identical shape but different sizes that can nest together like Russian dolls. And that is hugely awesome because it means that you can stack them into each other. It makes it way easier to transport. It makes it way easier to store the canoe. And because the framework is built in balanced tension, we don't need to have any permanent thwarts in there, which has other advantages for being able to trim the canoe for different wind and wave conditions. And also it allows for certain accessories like a pop-up sail that really wouldn't work in canoes that have to have thwarts to hold the shape across. Now, Another thing that these canoes will do that just has to do with the structure of how they're built is that they can be catamaran together. And catamaraning two canoes together is nothing new. We've seen it done with aluminum canoes for, you know, probably 50 or 60 years. But as modern canoe materials have gotten lighter and stiffer, it's no longer practical for most canoes to catamaran them together because the flexing would cause them to break apart. And you could potentially do this with the other style of skin-on-frame canoe, but usually the way the gunwale and rib attachments come together isn't robust enough to handle the twisting and the flexing forces with catamaran boards. Now, on the other hand, the way that our gunwales and ribs come together with the skin creates this really robust structure that's strong enough to hold a catamaran board attachment, but flexible enough to flex even in waves without actually damaging the canoe structure. And so the ability to catamaran two of these canoes together is not only interesting, it is a tremendous amount of fun. Myself and my girlfriend do it all the time, setting these up and then putting up the sails and running downwind. We've also used it to run whitewater rivers. Now, the last thing that's cool about these canoes, like I said before, is because they don't need to have any permanent thwarts to hold the shape. It means that we can have accessories that can pop up that would otherwise hit a thwart. And specifically, I'm talking about the pop-up sail system, which is just a super simple, compact folding sail that hinges off the keel at the bow and pops up anytime you need to catch a favorable breeze, but then when it's not blowing, it folds down and it tucks nice and tightly out of the way and you don't even notice it's there. And so that's been a really cool feature about these canoes. I love sailing canoes, although I don't like all of the attachments and clutter that comes with normal canoe sailing systems. So this kind of gives me the best of both worlds of just a pure paddling canoe that can catch the occasional breeze. So I just need to interrupt myself here for a minute because I realized while I was editing this video that I had completely forgotten to mention one of the last really neat things you can do with this canoe building system. And what that is because of the robustness of the gunwale and rib structure here, we have enough strength to mount a rowing outrigger in the middle of the canoe. Now, you could potentially even purchase a commercial rowing outrigger and put it into one of these boats, but I feel like that's a lot of clutter, and also a sliding seat rowing system is really better matched to a much longer boat. So what I prefer to do with this boat is just make a really simple fixed seat detachable outrigger that's going to give you a very similar rowing geometry to an Adirondack guide boat. And if you look on our website, you're going to find a separate course for building a really simple set of small boat oars and an outrigger that is compatible with this canoe design and many other canoe designs as well. So if you're someone like me who likes to paddle but you also like to row, this is a great way to get both experiences out of one watercraft. So those are the advantages to our canoe building system. Now let's talk about some of the disadvantages. The first one is that to build one of these canoes, you need to have really good wood to bend the ribs because the ribs get bent in by eye. If you're working with poor quality bending stock, it's really hard to achieve the good shapes that we need. And so I would say if you're considering building one of my boats, you want to check around to see if you have access to a good bending wood, which is going to be a clear, straight grained, high moisture content piece of ash, oak, or locust. Now, this is not the only choices, but I feel like those are the choices that work best for the large solo canoes and the tandem canoes, because you really have to have good wood to get symmetry in those boats. Now, if you just want to build one of our pack canoes, which is a small canoe that you can paddle with a double-bladed paddle, it is nice if you can get good wood for that, but I've seen people successfully build these out of non-traditional boat-building woods, like kiln-dried beech that's been soaked, or even rattan. And so, lots of options if you just want to build a small canoe, but if you're thinking about building a big one, you're going to need access to good bending wood. And you can check our skin-on-frame canoe building course for a document called bending oak suppliers, and that's going to give you a huge list of different bending oak suppliers in the United States. A lot of them will actually ship the oak to you. You might get a little bit of sticker shock when you see the price of that oak, but when you compare it to how much it would cost to build a plywood canoe mold, it ends up still being cheaper. And if you're building a skin-on-frame canoe over a plywood canoe mold, you're still going to need some kind of bending wood, because if you try to use too crappy a wood for that system, what ends up happening is that once you take the canoe off the form, it changes shape. It flexes open and it also starts to flex down on the ends. And so just because you're building over a mold doesn't mean you don't need to have good bending wood. So that's just something to think about. So the other thing we can't do is making really deep or really square shaped boats, because with a free bent system, what happens is that the deeper you get, the harder it is to get a good stable shape on the bottom. And so this system will make fairly stable canoes between 11 inches to about 13 inches deep. I've seen people go 14 inches with successful results. But generally, if you're looking to build deep canoes in the 14 to 16 inch range in the middle of the boat, this is not going to be the best system for that, because you can have a really hard time getting a good stable shape on the bottom. Now, you're also going to have a hard time if you want a canoe that's extremely flat bottomed. We can get reasonably stable bottoms, I would say very similar to the shapes that you can achieve in a wood canvas canoe, something like that. But if you're looking to get a super modern, ultra flat bottom canoe shape, that's not something that's going to work very well with this system. And if you want to know how flat or how stable our canoe shapes are, feel free to check through the website, look at the student builds. You can give me a call. If you're local, you can actually come borrow some of my canoes and try them out. I want to make sure that you have a really good sense of what we can and can't achieve there. I think we've got decent stability, but everybody has their own preferences for that. Now, the other thing that doesn't work very well is getting perfect symmetry in the largest sizes of boats. Now, I've been incredibly impressed by how good of symmetry that we can get in the pack canoes and in the mid-sized solo canoes. But when you get up into the tandem canoes, it is super hard using a free bent system to get absolutely perfect symmetry. All of the tandem canoes that I've built with this system look symmetrical to the eye, and the ones that I've seen my students build look symmetrical as well. But if you were to actually take a photograph of that and then flip the photograph around and superimpose them on each other, usually some elements of the canoe are about a quarter inch off to one side or the other. And that would actually be worse if you tried to do it with less than ideal bending stock. So if you want a canoe that paddles straight and looks symmetrical to your eye, you can definitely achieve that with this system. But if you want absolutely perfect mathematical symmetry, you're not gonna get it out of this system, at least not in the very largest sizes. Now, last thing to mention here, this is a pretty new type of canoe building. I've been building skin-on-frame kayaks for about 20 years. I think I'm pretty good at it. I've put about 1,500 boats on the water. By contrast, I've only been building skin-on-frame canoes for about 4 years now. I've built about 25 of them personally, and I've only put, with all my students, about 200 boats on the water. And so that's a big difference in experience between my level of experience with kayak building and my level of experience with canoe building. But at the same time, you got to start somewhere, and the system is evolving all the time, and it's significantly less expensive than my kayak building courses. And so the cool thing about this system is that if you're interested in it, but you want to wait a little bit to see how much further I can evolve the different designs, you can always buy it now and just sit on it, because you have lifetime access to these courses, and you can build as many canoes as you want from your course purchases. So anyways, hopefully that gives you a really kind of good overview of the advantages and disadvantages of this system. It's not a perfect system, just like any form of boat building, but if you like the advantages here more than you like the disadvantages over here, this might be a really great way for you to build a skin-on-frame canoe. All right, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. You can also find us on our website, capefalconkayaks.com, where I've got a bunch more skin-on-frame building videos, plan sets, and video courses. You can find us on Instagram, at capefalconbuilds, where we post a daily build blog of everything that we're doing here in the workshop. And even if you're not normally a social media person, I would highly encourage you to check out our Instagram, because there is so much more content there. And I'm constantly sharing building tips and tricks that you're not going to find anywhere else except for inside of my paid courses. So make sure you check that out. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time.